Hello and welcome to the Garrett's Test podcast. I surprised. I said I wasn't going to surprise you, and then I did it anyways.
Oh, yeah, I just sat down and looked up, and then you're...
That's awesome. Number 26, not 25, not 26. 26. I am one of your hosts, TBC Ekman. You can call me Teddy. I have with me, like I always do, every week, the man of the week, every week, Eric Bailey.
Hello.
Otherwise known as Legend PVM. Or Legend Bob, as I have heard before.
Old school.
Oh, dude, one of your friends, I think it was Gabe. I don't fully know who it was. It might have been Gabe and some other. I think it was mostly Gabe, though. He would just, like, every now and then, he would just call you Bob. And yeah, I'm like, that's...
It's great.
It's not... not right.
On Xbox 360, my gamer tag is still Legend Bob. Because it was just...
Interesting.
Random.
You should change it because you have the ability to do that. Unlike
for
on PlayStation.
Bucks. $10 actually.
Unlike on PlayStation, I would gladly pay a lot.
But mate, it's better. Like Xbox gives you a gamer tag to start out with, and mine was like Fluky Note 8823.
Fluky Note.
Yes, Fluky Note 8823. Some random numbers at the end. I just.
I always thought it was funny. I went to create mine because Clayton let me borrow his Xbox once, and I was like playing through some stoof, and I was making my Xbox Live because you know I didn't have one, so I was making it, and like it was like this is taken. How about this? And then it was just adding random words onto it, like ocean and like, stuff like that, and mountains.
Like a lot of name suggestors like do that. Like when I, you know, I like putting legend something in my screen names on RuneScape. They would be like, "Oh, that name is taken," and then it would be like legend something random, like legend ocean, legend this. I'm like, what?
It's like I'm not gonna just pick legend banana off
legend
your
banana.
Freaking. You know, we're basically just talking about sea nanners right now, and I didn't even realize it. But, yeah. Even though we just talked about Xbox, you know, we do it every now and then. We mostly like to focus on PlayStation. This is a Halo podcast. We mostly like to focus on PlayStation, Destiny, video games, general, TV, DC, comics, freaking all the movies, all sorts of stuff. So, one thing I was going to say. Have you seen any of the Mad Max movies before?
No, but I've heard they're really good.
I have not either, and I've heard they're amazing, and I've heard the most recent one is like the one of the best action movies ever, and I'm like, well.
I heard from a giant fan of the earlier movies that this one's like great. It's amazing, like 10 out of 10.
And I'm like, well, I would like to like to, but I don't. I haven't seen the others, and I have no means of seeing the others, like usual. I never have a way to see all the others. So I don't know. I would love to see all the Fast and Furious movies, but I'm not gonna like buy them all. You know what I mean? I just eating an ice cream sandwich. I'm so jealous. I had donuts earlier though. So.
I have a 24 pack.
A 24 pack of ice cream
for
sandwiches.
$5
Dang.
Bucks.
Dang. Yeah, that's amazing. Were you at, like, Sam's Club or Walmart or anything?
No, just Kroger.
Oh.
Right. Right over here.
That's surprising. Very surprising. I imagine at Sam's Club, you could get, like...
Right.
Like, 80 ice cream sandwiches for, like, $10. Just, like, a giant box. You're like, all right, got my ice cream sandwiches. Sam's Club is ridiculous. They do stuff like that. Like, with chips?
I want to go there.
Have you never been to Sam's?
Like, once.
Oh, okay. Yeah. It's
on the other side of town, so.
It's pretty crazy. And
did you get a discount card, too, or something?
You have to have a Sam's Club members card to even get in.
Because it's like a part of Walmart or something like that, right?
It's weird. I don't understand. It feels like it's super exclusive, but, like, I don't know. I don't know how one would go about just going to Sam's without being, like, a member or whatever. But anyways, I do want to go to Sam's and just get a bunch of ice cream sandwiches now. But, mate, so a couple of things happened in the past week. Oh, also, we're not live streaming this on Sunday, and this is not out on Monday, so GG. But the reason that was because I was down in Montgomery officially graduating and also playing a bunch of Trials of Osiris in Ryan's burning hot room. And yeah.
Well, just like Mercury, it's burning hot.
Hey, no. No, I'm just kidding. That was good. I liked it. But, yeah, so I got home late. Not late, but I got home at, like, 8, and I had to be at work at, like, 6 the next day or today. So I went to sleep early. So we did not record it yesterday. We are recording this on a Monday. This is releasing on Tuesday. This is going to be out on May 26th. 2015, if you are listening to this in the future.
This podcast has been dead for centuries.
Oh my gosh. what are you? Eobard Thawne, basically.
Maybe.
Well, I thought he was
the Doctor.
Or Rip Hunter. Random. Freaking the freaking Rory, you know, playing.
Oh yeah.
Playing Rip Hunter.
Well, what's his title again? Like,
I just said it, Rip Hunter. I said it like Rip 3 Hunter. Times. Yeah.
Okay, I didn't.
Yeah, they also mentioned him in the Flash. You know, Harrison mentioned him.
Mm.
I thought that was awesome. I'm super excited for that. I watched an interview. Dude, remember that one time we read a casting of this guy, this black guy who was cast as an athlete who blah blah blah, like broke a teenage athlete who like broke his arm or whatever, then he's working at Star Labs and stuff like that. It was like basically almost shot for shot of like Cyborg. I saw an interview today where they were talking to that guy, and she was like, she went over his origin. He was like, yeah, it's true. And then she's like, will you be wearing any sort of metal the upcoming show? And he's like, I guess you're gonna have to watch and see. So like, what's weirding me out is that his name is like not Cyborg's name. It's like not Victor Stone, it's another dude. It's like Jay Jim. Something it's just another Jim. Name, but like the exact same story, it seems.
Interesting.
I'm sure they'll do something different with him. They're doing so much stuff different than the comics, like White Canary. That's not a thing.
Crazy, but
it's not a thing, but it is in. It's the thing now, according to CW.
They're changing life.
Oh, so they're changing. They're going into parallel dimensions and changing it because Greg Berlanti is the Flash. He's just doing. It's just all an elaborate cover up. Yeah. Oh, so Eric, what have you been playing? I just thought of that.
Yeah. So obviously
in the past
Destiny.
House of Wolves came out.
Bam, bam, bam. Last Tuesday.
Bam.
At 1 PM my time.
Yeah, 12 for me. Noon.
And we're all there. I think I got the first exotic in
He's still like, close. I got the first exotic in the world. Close.
I got purifier robes.
You were definitely
like,
one of
like
the first.
Legendary engram.
Yeah. Dude, we'll have a whole part today.
Yeah, we're gonna like talk about that.
Talk about House of Wolves and all the different sections of it.
Witcher
3
came out as well.
Oh baby, a triple.
And literally a triple because it's the third game.
Wow, yeah. it's true though.
But yeah,
intentional.
That game. And what else have I been playing? I played some Persona 4 actually.
Nice
surprise. Because my power went out, and it was like 2:30. I was like, I still want to play something. So I played P4 on my bed.
Nice.
And I leveled up my characters a few times. And,
cool.
And,
dude.
Yeah.
I finally, like, just sprung for it. I've been wanting to get the 64-gigabyte card forever, and I finally just sprung for it. So that came in last week, or a couple of days ago. So right now, I am just redownloading all my games, and it's been taking like a day because it's a lot of games.
Let me give you your old one because the one I have is so tiny.
I completely should have thought of that before I threw it away. I literally looked at it and I'm like, could I sell this? Could I give? I didn't think, could I give this to anybody? Because it didn't cross my mind. I'm like, I can't really sell this. It won't be worth it. I don't know what else I can do with it. I mean, I don't know. And then I just tossed it. The trash is literally, I just took it out. It goes out on Monday. I don't know what bag is it. It is. I'm not gonna go
run. Use a metal detector.
I'm not gonna go open, go in the road and be like,
Where's my?
Where's the card? And the card is so small though. So like, yeah. There's no freaking way. It's like way smaller than a regular SD card.
Dump the bags out all over the
all over the road, just. I gotta just turn into Gollum.
Actually, just get your dog to rip it open and blame it on the dog. There you go.
It's true. There we go. But I really should have thought of that. Oh, well, I didn't.
Dang it.
I'm sorry. What? How
I wanted
unfortunate
to download,
is this?
One game.
Yeah.
FPS.
You definitely need to, like, somehow queue that up and then, like, cancel the download so that you have it when there's an actual, when you get a bigger card. Just like.
What is it? Killzone?
Killzone Mercenary.
Yeah, I tried to download it, but of course it didn't work. So, I mean, I should be able to, like, re-download it once I have a bigger one.
Okay. Yeah, you should. That should have done the trick. But I ordered the 64-gigabyte card, and I ordered, which came, like, a couple of days ago, and I also ordered, I told you, the 2-terabyte hard drive to go in my PS4 so I can move the 1-terabyte in there. Over to my PS3.
Hey,
so
you're buying all these little accessories when you could be upgrading your PC.
That ain't true. But I think all my games are done, so I'm going to see how many games I have on here and how much space is left. I bet because before my 32, I didn't download old games because I just sort of like... I picked and choosed... And now I went through and I didn't pick and choose, and I'm like, all right, downloading everything. So I bet there actually isn't much space left.
And before your Persona 4 save gets corrupted.
My Persona 4 is actually the only game I have on here that is on a card. Like, it is a card. I went and picked it up from GameStop, then every other game I have on my Vita is digital.
See.
So GG. But... so is that all you've been playing? I'll try and think of anything.
Persona 4, Destiny, Witcher 3.
GG.
PC, rip in peace.
Freaking Witcher. Eric meant to get the PS4 version, but he went to GameStop.
Like, thought about it, and I, like, overthunk it, and decided to get PC.
He sort of got sidetracked and started thinking, can I run it? And then immediately when he realized
that
he could, he was like...
The thought of just being able to run it on my PC was, like, really just great. And then I just got caught up with it, and I thought about it, like, why did I do this? I wanted the other extra stuff.
Yeah, later...
I wanted physical. I love physical.
Yeah, when he got home, he was like, why did I... What? And now he's...
I was so ashamed. I might just go buy it again. I'm thinking about it. I haven't got that far in the game, even with 12 hours.
Dang. Yeah, it's crazy. Oh, man. Oh, I want to talk about my backlog that I made earlier. Because I think that's cool.
That was ridiculous.
I think it's cool. But, anyways, I don't know. Now, what have I been playing? I've been playing Destiny, of course. House of Wolves. So much Destiny. Witcher 3. Freaking so much Witcher because it's really good. I played something earlier in the week that I literally thought to myself, man, I should write this down so that I don't forget. But I don't know what it was. I played Hohokam today, which is such a relaxing game. It's like so chill, but
it's weird.
Yeah, it's very odd.
I don't know how to progress. You just keep going.
You just keep, going around doing things. I don't know. That's basically it. I played some more stuff.
I played some Ether 1 too. That game is great.
Yeah. I mean, sure. I will.
You need to try it.
I mean, I will. It's there.
It's awesome.
It's just, we'll talk about that later. Because that should be a whole theme in and of itself, just in general. Just, backlogs of games that gamers keep just creating for themselves.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Anyways, Yeah, I don't think I did any. Yeah, I think that was it. Other than Vita stuff, which is I play Persona 4 at least like 5 minutes a week. You know, if
right.
I mean, I normally play more than that, but at some point I open the game during the week.
Right.
But
like I would play longer, but I just sit down for like 30 minutes and do a dungeon.
Yeah.
Not do a dungeon, but like like grind a little, and I'm like, okay, that was okay, and I'm just trying to get back to like the social stuff. Yeah,
dude. See, I had a spell when I went for social stuff for just ever for True. So long for like 4 months or something without a dungeon, and by that time I was like, oh, okay, I'm kind of ready for a dungeon, but I just checked how much space I have on my Vita. With all of my games downloaded, which I can name in a second, I have 29 gigs still free.
Oh my gosh.
GG. I have Freedom Wars downloaded, Shovel Knight, Ollie Ollie 2, Rayman Origins, Killzone Mercenary, Sonic Racing Transformed,
yes.
Limbo, Urban Trial Freestyle, which is basically just a Trials ripoff for the PlayStation, because they originally... They wouldn't, like, it was a Microsoft thing, it was on Xbox, and so they were just like, we're just gonna make this knockoff for the Vita. And Velocity 2X, Stealth Inc, A Clone in the Dark, Titan Attacks, which is awesome.
Yeah.
Wipeout 2048, Sly Cooper, A Thieves in Time, the fourth Sly Cooper, which I have yet to play, because I want to play through the original again, before I play that one. Resogun, Mod Nation Racers, Road Trip, Minecraft, of course. AC3 Liberation, PlayStation All-Stars Battle Royale, Super Stardust Delta, freaking Housemarque, and Uncharted Golden Abyss. So, like, with all that, I still have 29 gigs. So, G freaking G. Sony, thank you so much, even though your memory card's way overpriced. Way, way overpriced.
How much did that one cost?
Like, $80.
Oh my god.
They used to cost 100.
A little chip.
Yeah, dude, the 64 gigabyte used to be 100. A regular memory card, a regular 64 like, okay, let's just compare. I got a 64 gigabyte, whatever it's called, just micro SD or whatever, for my phone, for $30, and then I get it for my Vita for $80. Like, that's dumb. Anyways, what was I gonna say? Yeah, so that's what I've been playing. That's what Eric's been playing. Yep. Let's cover this actual... I have, like, two pieces of news from the past week. That's it. Like, two. And then we can talk about House of Wolves. We can talk about Eric's Hunt the Truth thing. And then we can talk about Trials of Osiris and just all sorts of stuff. And Witcher 3. I want to talk about that.
We should talk about the truth with you, but...
Well, you know.
You would love it. And they're like 20-minute episodes. You sit there and do bounties.
Do you know the last time I did bounties, Eric? Do you have any idea? No. Like, probably like last House Tuesday.
Wolves. Yeah, Tuesday.
Last, like, no. No, I didn't. No, like last Monday.
Did the wanted bounties.
I did not do those. I have not done those. I did those the week before House of Wolves dropped. That was the last time I did bounties.
No, you're thinking about those other bounties. I'm talking about the wanted ones.
I know. I did not do those. The ones from Petra now that are in the reef, I have not done those. No, I have not done bounties since House of Wolves release. I did bounties like 2 Saturdays ago, now that I think about it. It was the last time that I had time to sit down and just do bounties. So, yeah, it doesn't happen often. It's happening more often, but not often. Anyways.
Yeah, you watch those or listen to them because they're awesome. Anyway.
Look at this orc. He's beautiful. What a beautiful
specimen. Yeah, Orgrim.
Look at him. Just going to zoom into his eyes. It's
pretty legit. And this is like a live action, right?
Yes. This is a movie. But, yeah, it's directed by a guy named Duncan Jones.
Donkey Jones?
Yes. But it was supposed to come out like Christmas of this year, if I remember correctly, and now I think it's coming out. Yeah, it says right here, Warcraft releases June 10th, 2016, so they pushed it like 6 months, which is fine. I honestly thought, I kept seeing that it was coming out like Christmas of this year, and I'm like, really? I haven't seen like anything about it. But I'm sure once it gets closer to June 10th, we'll actually see like a ton of stuff about it. There will be trailers out the wazoo. I totally am going to see this in theaters. So the World of Warcraft universe is, like, insane. I always said that that was the best thing about World of Warcraft. It's hard
to
wrap
your head around it because there's so much that we, like, weren't there to experience.
Yeah.
When it first came in.
I always said that that is the best part of World of Warcraft to me, is just the universe. Like, it's so good. Super well developed. There's a ton of stuff. And it's awesome. So, I'm sure there's tons of potential for an awesome story in this really cool universe. So I'm definitely gonna see that.
Yeah.
You should get another plane ticket and fly down for that.
Oh. What you should do. I thought we were doing that for Star Wars.
Exactly. You use your Star Wars one and then you get another one. And then you go down.
Okay.
He has go out and grab one. He has go out and be like, "Hey, I need a ticket down to Nashville, Tennessee. Here's $1,000. Get me a first class, baby." And she's.
You know what's funny? The one like plane ticket that I still have is for first class.
Oh, that's.
But
awesome.
They're on crap airplanes. Oh. So the first class is pretty much regular class.
Oh, that's a bummer. I was about to say, if it's like first class on a regular one,
but you could get free like food and drinks and everything. You know, like they just keep coming to ask you, and they'll do anything for you. The attendants or whatever, it's great.
They will do anything for you.
Literally, they'll like rub your back. Or something.
Anything.
Yes, anything, anything. No.
GG. But they will get you food and drink,
like little. Pretzel snacks and like trail mix and stuff. You can get like a sandwich and
That's always
freaking alcohol if you were the age.
I never take flights long enough to like give you actual like food, but they always give you like, here, have a pretzel bag, you know, just have a little pretzel, because like the flights that I ever go on are like 2 hours long, and they like that's like not enough time for them apparently to give me food.
I don't know. But like the chick would like ask if I wanted like a drink, I would be like, just give me a Coke, and she would come out with this little thing of just Coke. I'm like, this is nice.
This is how airlines work. Yes. That's funny. So did you hear, mate, Need for Speed is getting
The only one I care about is Carbon.
Yeah, I don't care about Need for Speed at all. But I thought this was worth mentioning was a good because it's a huge franchise. Like, this is I don't know. This has been around forever, and people really like it. I'm not into racing games like at all, other than kart racers. Kart racers are the crap. They are the best. I love kart racers. But Need for Speed, it was never really my thing. But, yeah, I just thought I would cover it. It is getting an official reboot. The next game in the franchise will just be a complete reboot. So do you think they're just going to call it Need for Speed?
And like, yeah, probably just else? Like Battlefront.
Oh, man. That's crazy. But, yeah, it's getting a reboot, which, I don't know. As someone not super into the franchise, I don't
or
fully
it could be
know.
Need for Speed. Gotta go fast.
Need for Speed, gotta go fast. There. With special appearance from Sonic the Hedgehog. But I think it's, I don't know. I'm not super into the series, so I don't know. But, like, I don't know. It's been around forever. So, like, it sounds about time.
What was it? Need for Speed Rivals or whatever uses the Frostbite 3 engine. Same one that Battlefield 4 uses. So that's a cool fact.
Need for Speed fact.
Yeah. It's like the only thing I care about. About Need for Speed, really.
But, Yeah, it seems like it was about time, just because it's super old. I think Metal Gear needs a reboot. That's my opinion. I don't think it will get one, but I think a ton of fans will just freaking riot in their britches if this happens. If that happens. But, I mean, as someone who has tried to get into the old Metal Gear games, what? A
remaster of Uncharted.
Oh, my gosh. That I'm telling you, it's going to happen at E3. It's going to happen. They're going to be like, it's coming in the fall. You can play it while you wait on Uncharted 4. Oh.
Yeah.
How awesome would that be?
Freaking ridiculous.
Holy crap. The only thing that would be even better would be Infamous 1 and 2 remastered as well on the same day.
Yeah. Oh, my gosh, yeah.
That'd be great.
Or trophies to get.
Oh, dude, yes. One of the things along with my giant backlog of games is that I want to go back and platinum Infamous 2, because I consider Infamous 2 like my favorite game, and like I've replayed the game like 6 times, but when I was doing that I was super young and I didn't know anything about trophies, so I just replayed the game and I'm like, this is great. But if I was doing that now and I found a game I love, I would immediately just be like, all right, let's go for the platinum. But I didn't know about it. So I just kept replaying the game on the good. I didn't even do it on evil, I think. Out of the 6 times I replayed it, I don't think I played it on evil. So I need to go back and do that. And I want to go back and do that. But you know, there's just not enough time. It's not enough time.
So much out of it.
Especially with Destiny. I was really thinking about it. If I didn't play Destiny, I would beat so many games. So many games would be beaten. It wouldn't even be a problem. But yeah, anyways, Need for Speed, getting a reboot, it is happening. Whether you are prepared for it or not, get prepared, because it's happening. Gotta go fast. Anyways, let's see here. Ugh. So, what do you want to talk about? Do you want to talk about Hunt the Truth?
Sure.
Okay, go for it.
Hunt, if you don't know already... you've probably seen it somewhere on like YouTube, Twitch, anywhere on the internet, for ads for the Hunt the Truth, thing that Microsoft is doing, or 343 and Microsoft are doing for Halo 5. And it's pretty much audiobooks, but there's no actual book.
Yeah.
And they have a really good voice actor for this, and voice actors, I should say. And, like, at first I thought it was just going to be some, like, information on what was going to come into Halo 5. But, no, it's actually, like, it's like you're playing the Halo game when you're not playing and you're not seeing anything, but you're listening and you're imagining what's going on, but it's, like, really epic and intense. But the cool thing about it is that these things you're listening to is, like, it's, like... it's actually happening in our universe, but it's, of course it's not, because it's fiction.
Yeah.
But in the episodes are put out by Benjamin, and it's trying to make it look like it's part of our universe, but it's not really. But so it's kind of cool. They're trying to do something different for Halo 5, and it's really good. Like, get on the edge of your seat. Like, what's going on? I need to... to stop playing Destiny. Let's, like, look at the screen. Look at the volume bar or the waves on SoundCloud or whatever they're called.
Dang. So you stopped everything and you're like, yeah.
What's going to happen here? Like, it was intense. Especially last episode, because something big happened and crap went down. So
I was telling Erica before we started that I got my tax return check, I got a decent amount of money, and I also have a paycheck coming next week. So I'm thinking of just like saving it, figuring out what to do with it. But one of the things I might do with it is just freaking get an Xbox One Master Chief Collection. Just play through all the Xbox games, or the Halo games, because I really want to. But
gosh, dude, you could.
I could, but there are many things that I could do.
Dude, I'm getting a job too, which means I can get one too, and we can play through them together. And it'd be the great, best time in the world.
Too bad there's no trophies.
Oh, yeah.
GG.
Lots of achievements.
I know, but no trophies. Achievements.
So what does it matter?
They're the same thing.
What does it matter? It's not going to my trophy level. There's it's going to my dang achievements, my gamer score.
No one cares about gamer score.
People care about gamer score. People care about gamer score. People care about trophies. They're just different people.
I just look at my gamer score and be like, oh, yeah, I have 25,000 gamer score. Whatever.
But, like, see, now you care a little bit about trophies. So if you had been with
because
Xbox
for, like,
a while. Because
they're singular things, and, like, they're specifically bronze.
Oh, are you saying that the trophy system itself is better than the achievement system?
Obviously, because
are these the fighting words you're throwing out right now?
Well, everyone can agree that freaking the trophy system is better because each freaking trophy has its own specific tier or something. While on Xbox, it's just numbers, and it's hard to discern which one's better or not. Well, I mean, of course you can discern 1,000 is better than a 10 gamer.
Yeah, score. I don't fully agree with that. The only thing that I think is better about the trophy system than the achievement system is platinums. Instead of like, oh, I finally 100%ed the game. Like, you get a platinum. And, like, when you look at somebody's profile, you see how many platinums they have. That's, like, the only thing that I think is better. Like, I completely disagree that the bronze, silver, and gold are better than the numbers because it's basically the same thing. You know, 5, 10, 30. You know, it's just third, second, and first. But, yeah, they're basically the same thing. People just, like, if you had an Xbox, like, if you got an Xbox One instead of a 360 and you were playing with all your friends, or instead of a PS4, and you were playing with all your friends on the Xbox, you would eventually start to care about it. Like, you've slowly started to care about trophies a little bit.
Right.
So, just different people care about the different
sides. I think the difference is, like, with trophies, they're actually, like, something. There's a clear list. I mean, of course, they're very similar, of course, but, like, each, it's different. I don't know. Because on Xbox, literally, they just pop up on your screen, and they go away, and it's like, okay, cool.
That's exactly what happens on PlayStation.
I know. It's weird, though.
Yeah, it's because you actually, it's because you care about, like, you've dedicated your time to a certain ecosystem so that, you know, I don't know. Like, if I went on Xbox and I'm playing the Master Chief Collection, I'm not in any way playing that for the achievements because I'm not on that ecosystem. I'm on PlayStation. I've been playing PlayStation for years and years. I'm not going to, like, I can't
but
do
see,
both.
You can say the same thing about Steam, though. They have achievements, but they're like, there's.
Why do people not care about that? What is wrong with the Steam achievement system? Because no one cares about Steam achievements.
Yeah, it's weird.
I don't know. I think it's because they make it, like, very unclear. Like, when you look at, like, you know, when you look at a friend's profile on Xbox or PlayStation, you see the gamer score, you see the trophy level.
Right, they're, like, right there in your face.
But on
Steam, how much they've.
You kind of don't see anything. You look and you see their Steam level, but that's, like, because of purchases.
Right.
Fix your crap, Steam. Anyway. So, Hunt the Truth is really cool, according to
Yeah,
Eric.
Hunt the Truth is
great. I will get into that one day. One day. Somewhere over the rainbow is where Halo lies for me. So, let's talk about The Witcher. Let's talk about The Witcher. The Witcher 3, A Wild Hunt, is really freaking good. I don't want to spend too much time on this.
Some call it just Witcher, The Wild Hunt.
Yeah. That's basically the...
Okay.
They originally, the developers were like, yeah, we kind of removed it from the title, the 3. And then they're like, oh, no, it's there when it released. So, right. I don't know. But, yeah, so I don't want to spend too much time talking about this because we still have to talk about House of Wolves and we still have to talk about the Flash finale, which was... insanity. But all I want to say for this, for me at least, is basically just like, it's insane. It's really good.
There's one thing about Witcher that I really, really like it compared to any other game that has dismemberment and like gore. There is one thing about Witcher that makes it so satisfying that your character doesn't do some stupid, fancy, freaking move and then slow-mo.
Yeah.
I, for some reason, I don't like when, like on Skyrim, when you dismember someone, it goes in slow-mo and it's all choppy and
yeah,
cut off their head, and then like 5 minutes later, you finally can play again. When you cut someone's head off, you just keep going. You're just
it does. It's
great.
The only time it ever slows down for dismemberment is when it's like the last enemy that you're facing, and then it'll slow down. But it's not even super slow. Like it's just a tiny bit it slower than normal. And
does a little thing really fast. So.
Yeah,
I like it because I just like I was a bunch of group of like bandits. I cut off someone's arm in the middle of it. It was awesome.
And you know what's awesome now that I'm thinking about it, is that basically like when you get into the world and when you get into the White Orchard, basically everything is unlocked. Like you slowly get the alchemy and the crossbow, but like, and then that's it. Like you're like, okay, go into the world. And I think that's awesome because, like, I like skill trees. Everyone likes skill trees to some degree. But to some degree, I also sometimes like in Assassin's Creed or Shadow of Mordor, I'm not specifically sure about this, but in some games like that, there are modes, there are, like, unlockables that, like, unlocks your fatalities and your slow-mo. Whereas, like, when you go into the world of The Witcher, like, you got it all. You didn't unlock something to have this cool slow-mo effect.
Right.
You're just doing your normal combat, and it does the cool slow-mo thing, and you didn't have to worry about it. It's great.
I've gotten used to the slow, or the not the slow-mo, but the combat, too, because at first I was like, what do I do? I keep on getting comboed by these the drowners. Good. But then I realized that you just need to, like, do the small dodge, not the roll. Just to, like, get behind him, then...
I've still been doing the roll, and I'm fine. I do the little dodge every now and then.
Sometimes I just get in a bad spot, and I'm, like, rolling, roll, roll, roll.
Yeah. So you had you had problems with the drowners?
Yeah, they just, like... I couldn't figure out how to evade them correctly, and I kept on getting hit over and over. And plus, I was really underleveled.
The only time that I ever died was, like... I don't even remember what it was. But I did not die to the griffin.
Neither did I.
I got really close, but I didn't.
I kept on using the shield, and then I used Thunderbolt to get extra damage. I was using heavy attacks.
I didn't even do any of that, though. Bam. When I came out of that, I was like, man, I'm dumb. I could have cut that a lot. That would have been a lot cleaner if I had done other stuff. I just basically shot it with a crossbow and smacked it. That was it. Like, that's how... I don't know. I kind of think the combat itself is... very kind of easy to me and kind of Assassin's Creed a little bit, not with like the counters, but like the way you move is a little bit Assassin's Creed-y, which I like. I'm used to it. I don't know, I didn't have much problems with the combat. It was really I don't know, the small attack, like the normal fast attack, is really powerful. Like if you just get a hit on something and just keep going, unless it's like that one enemy with a shield. Yeah, you it's basically a stun lock. Like, you're just like, all right, done.
So, yeah, if you have a shield, you need to use your force push.
But, like, you can do that, you can do the fire, and then you can also do the freaking, like, you can do a counter on those. What I basically do with the shield guy is I try and save him for last, and then me and him have a little one-on-one fight, and basically I either do the Ard or the Igni or the Axie or whatever. Like, any of those three work, and then you stun, and then you hit him, like, once or twice, and then he puts the shield back up, and then you have a little bit to, while your sign is recharging, to do a counter, and then it does basically the same thing, and then I get one or two hits in, and by then my sign is up, and I'm like, all right. And I don't know, I'm really liking that game. I want to get back to it.
Yeah.
I want to get back to it. I haven't played it in a couple of days.
It's
a lot of fun.
It looked a little better for me on PC. Okay, like, okay, actually, no, I can make it. It looks good. It's just...
it doesn't run super well.
It since it's on PC, it has its times to where it dips below 30, and it's really annoying.
Yeah, man. Yemen, the map. Uncharted 3 multiplayer. And
the real place.
Yes, Yemen, the real place. Shout out to you, Yemen. Unlike Egypt, you're not all dead.
The Yemen pirates.
Unlike Egypt, you're not all dead there. So yeah, I one more thing about The Witcher, and then we'll get on to we'll cover the Flash, and then we'll spend the rest of our time on House of Wolves. Okay. Mix it up. One more thing about The Witcher is that basically... Oh, I also need to do my backlog thing. Basically, I was playing Destiny a lot, and I love Destiny, but I was really kind of just craving a single-player world and story mm-hmm. to just get lost in. And I was like, oh, I can go back to Mass Effect, I can go to Ni No Kuni, and it'll be fine. But then this game came out, and I wasn't, like, I forgot about that, and then it just happened, and I was like, all I wanted to do was play the game. And right. and it's super refreshing. It's really refreshing.
Is, yeah. Another thing I like about it is the exploration. It's kind of like ESO, mm-hmm. where you go around exploring places.
It's so good. I need to get back to it. Let's cover my backlog real quick, because I find that interesting. And then we can talk about Flash and...
Your backlog is ridiculous.
Yeah. We also need to not forget the drope. I like that you put that in there, because we forgot it last week.
Yeah.
I love how, like, an hour later, I said, later that night. Like, we were just doing stuff, and then later that night, I was sitting there, and then I was like, crap, we forgot the drope. And it just, like, hit me. Anyways, so I'm going to go to this website here and show everyone on the video podcast what I'm talking about. But if you're listening, I will explain as well. So basically, there's a website called How Long to Beat. And you can type in a game. And it tells you, like, you know, the main story. And then, like, a completionist. And then, like, if you rush it, how long it takes on each one of those. And there, if you have an account, you can just press plus backlog. And it adds it to your backlog. So, here, I'll show this here. Basically, I added all the games that I really want to beat that I own. So,
yeah.
And then you can put in time to beat, and it shows the highest time to the lowest time. So I've been, what I did, I only had like 30 minutes before I had to eat dinner. I started with the lowest one, and I played Hohokam for a bit. So, also, actually, that would not be the lowest one. This is messed up. That would be in between here and here. Anyways, the lowest one would have been Unfinished Swan, and then Hohokam, and then Flower, and then either one. But the point is that, I don't know. Like, Destiny, if I wasn't playing Destiny, this wouldn't be a problem.
You know, it's funny, because Destiny doesn't really have, like, a time to beat.
Yeah, because Destiny is infinite. So G freaking G.
Yeah.
Unlike all these other games where, like, if I just sat down and went at them for, like, a week. I posted this on Kind of Funny, the Facebook page. And they were like, just take a month off of Destiny and just see how much you can do and then go back. And I was like, I might do that in, like, June or July. Just, like, take a month off and just go. Like, every night, do stuff and see if I can beat it. Or not beat this backlog, but, like, clear some of it. Yeah. So I might do that, but then again, Destiny's really freaking awesome. So,
true. It's
a problem. But, yeah, I have Borderlands 2, Persona 4, The Witcher 3, all the Mass Effect games, because I bought the trilogy, Ni No Kuni, Bloodborne, Bioshock Infinite, which, to be fair, I'm already through the majority of that game, so that's not as big of a time. I want to play the Sly Collection before I play Sly 4. Killzone Mercenary I want to beat. Child of Light. Gravity Rush. I need to go through The Walking Dead Season 1 again on PS4 so that I can... if they ever do a Season 3, I can play it on PlayStation. And free trophies. So, yeah. I'm also almost done with Call of Duty Advanced Warfare campaign.
Really?
So that's not too big of a thing. And The Wolf Among Us. Lots of stuff. Tomb Raider is on there. A lot of stuff. But yeah, I'm sure we all
so good.
Yeah, I'm sure we all have backlogs like that. I don't know. Leave in the comment if you have gotten addicted to a game recently or in any sort of time period that and you did not have the chance to finish a game that you bought, let me know. Because I'm sure you have at least one. Like, you most likely have close to mine, which was like 24.
Yeah.
Eric probably has, like, not as many, not, like, 24. You probably have, like, if I were to guess, you probably have, like, 8 that you really want to finish but haven't.
You'd be surprised.
You should go through and make a backlog. I'd be interested to see that.
Dude, it's more than just stuff on freaking PSN, and like I have an unopened copy of Halo Wars on 360. It still has a plastic on it.
Well, what you should do...
That is like...
What we should do is we should have Ryan do this as well, and we should all do it together, and like 1 month, just like set it up, set everyone's backlog up, and either for... We could do it for like a week, and just like every night, just do our own thing, and right. then see how much progress each of us makes, how many games we knock out, and all that. That'd be fun.
Funny, one game I haven't beat on the PS4 yet.
Oh, gosh. Guess what? Infamous First Light, you still haven't. Oh, wow. Wow. You didn't beat that?
I didn't beat it on the PS4.
Frick, man. Why? Yeah. I
don't know. I don't remember how far I got, but man.
That's crazy.
I just didn't beat it.
You were playing it a lot, so I
did when I first got it, so.
Huh. Anyways.
I'll need to... So.
Yeah, you should do that. We should do that though. Maybe in June, maybe in July, maybe sometime soon. I don't know. But there's House of Wolves to play. We gotta get the exotics. We gotta get everything.
I feel like the longest one to take to beat will probably be this.
Yeah. Oh yeah. On the backlog, that is number one. And I didn't even put the pre-sequel. I just put Borderlands 2 Game of the Year Edition, and that's like 250 hours.
How much was Bloodborne?
Let me look. I would assume...
I have, like, 90 hours in it.
I would assume, like, 80.
Yeah, 80. Yes. Is about when I beat it.
It says... But you went for trophies and whatnot.
Well, I'm still done with trophies.
Yeah, know. Completionist is 72, so...
Completionist is 72?
Completionist is what I count. Yeah, some of this is a little bit low, some of it's a little high.
Okay, I guess if you did Chalice that means route... the game, then yes, you could do it in 72, but if you do like the whole game and then start doing Chalice Dungeons, no, it's like it's gonna be like well over 100, so.
Yeah, it's an average, you know, it's an average. So I don't know, let's talk about Destiny and then Flash. I'm changing it back to the old way. I was like, let's do it a new way, and then I'm like, no, let's go back. So House of Wolves came out on Tuesday.
And there was that was the Engram Apocalypse.
Yeah, Master Yves and Master Rahul were just
Master Ives. That's
they were just swamped.
Swamped. And he gave me an exotic.
Working overtime. Yeah, well, he's a piece.
He also
of crap.
Gave me a ram from one Engram. Yeah, holy crap!
Yeah, well, he's a piece of crap.
And he also gave me a celestial.
You guys suck. You guys are the worst. I am so salty.
I didn't get
salty.
An Eternal Warrior.
I am so salty. You got an exotic. I don't have an exotic from House of Wolves. I don't have one.
I have three.
Yeah, well, you could suck my balls. But yeah, I'm super salty about that.
Ryan got has like all four. Freaking three, I
What's
think.
What's funny
no,
is that
no.
none of us have guns. No one has an exotic weapon yet.
The only way to get the guns I've seen is from the 34 and 35.
Yeah.
Prism of Elders.
Yeah.
You get the Elder Cipher, then you have to wait 4 days for the bounty to complete or something.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm super excited to play more and eventually get those exotics. But right now, I don't have any, and these pieces of crap have a ton. But,
three.
Yeah. Anyways, House of Wolves. Let's go through like each piece of content and say give like a little short review, like the story missions. Let's start there.
Story missions are great.
Super good.
They tell about Skolas being released from the Nine. Not sure how they were released from the Nine, but. Since Skolas is free, he is in search of Vex technology to become pretty much OP.
Basically.
He got Vex technology near the end of the story missions, and that allowed him to draw wolves, not literal wolves, but like fallen wolves faction from past and future to create a giant freaking army, but we stopped him. Of course. Guardians coming to save the day. But yeah, he was using Vex technology, and he was going to become OP. He was using oracles. He was tapping oracles to get this Vex technology.
Yeah.
Vault of Glass.
Basically, the best thing about the story missions is that it was all a really cohesive plot. It was like, Skolas is out. He's there. go stop him. And it the way I'm saying this makes it sound like Crota, but the Crota story, but it's a lot better. It's like, and Varix and Petra during your missions will like talk to each other. And the voice acting is a lot better than Eris. It's like,
Eris is still gold.
The characters themselves are just
forever bonded guardians.
What?
Yeah, freaking Eris. You just walk up to her and she's like, "We are forever bonded, guardian."
Yes, this is true.
Like,
yeah, but
at least she screeches. But,
but yeah, Eris is. I'm saying Petra and Varix are better characters. Like, they have depth. They have a backstory. And Eris is just like, "I failed. You have to succeed. I need vengeance." Ah! And that's like all I know of Eris.
Yeah.
Whereas like Petra, I feel like these two have like actual stories.
See, if you like stand around Eris though, like yesterday I stand around Eris for like 30 minutes for some reason, and I listened to her dialogue, and she literally was a guardian, and the hive took one of her eyes, and she took three back, and now she can see everything related to darkness.
Yeah.
Apparently.
So,
it's
like,
really freaky, and she's like into some weird crap.
Like everything in Destiny. Everything in Destiny has an awesome story. It's just really hidden and not presented well. Darkblow was not presented well. But like this has a great story and it has awesome lore as well, but the main story itself was just presented well this time.
So, yeah.
So the main story missions were awesome and a really cohesive plot. And a really great beginning, good middle, and then like an awesome climax.
Nothing very
like it worked,
narrative,
and then
though.
It was done.
Though, I mean, there wasn't any talking from your guardian.
What do you mean nothing narrative? There was more dialogue than normal.
Yes.
You had Petra and you had Varix talking more.
I'm not saying it was bad. Same what happened.
You were saying there's less narrative. There's a billion times more narrative. There's more presentation. There's more dialogue.
Overcome.
It's more of a cohesive plot. Yeah. Yeah, it's true. So, yeah. There was more narrative. But, anyways, story missions were great.
Mm-hmm.
And the strike... Let's move on to the strike.
It's awesome.
The strike was great.
You follow the boss throughout. And granted, he has a little bit more health than most bosses, because you get to do damage to him multiple times.
Your damage you do in each room actually matters instead of like Omnigal.
Although so there is a point to where he becomes immune and he moves on. But
at least it says immune instead of like doing a bunch of damage and then you go into the next room and it's gone. Yeah. So they learn from their mistakes. The Skullless room itself is a lot bigger than like the Omnigal room.
Mm-hmm.
So that's good.
Wait, didn't you mean Tanix?
Tanix, yeah, my bad. Tanix.
Yeah.
The Tanix room in itself.
Tanix the Scarred.
It's better.
Yeah.
Strike's awesome. Really good Nightfall. And then after that, there's Prison of Elders. Ah! Prison of Elders.
Yeah.
Prison of Elders was really good. I was listening to Fireteam chat, and basically they were talking about Prison of Elders, and they're like, it's really fun, but it's hard to describe why it's really fun. So I kind of basically agree with that. Like, you kind of have to play it for yourself. It's really, really fun.
The 34 and 35 have really cool mechanics.
They have really cool mechanics, and it's a horde mode. Like,
and it's random every reset.
Yeah. Yeah, level 32 and 34 will be different next week, which is crazy. Because, like, we worked up strategies for this 34. And then next week, it's going to be a new thing. It's crazy.
True.
Prison of Elders is insanely good. 10
out of 10. It's great.
Story missions were like, 8 out of 10. Like, Strike was like 9 out of 10. Prison of Elders, 10. Freaking, 10.
It's awesome. Only thing I would change about Prison of Elders is that there should be a higher chance of getting treasure keys.
Yes. I think treasure keys should drop once a week on the 35 or 34, whichever you do first.
Yeah, definitely.
But no, treasure keys are super rare. But people have been saying that, but it's very possible that it's similar to the Crux, as in, like, because we had them in our inventory the first week or something, they'll just start dropping this week. You don't know.
Yeah, that's true.
It's possible. It's not super likely,
But I'd say it's like 40% likely. Not halfway, but still, maybe like 50. I don't know. But it's possible. So yeah, Prison Elders is amazing. And also, honestly, I think might be my favorite thing. No, Prison Elders is my favorite. Trials of Osiris is a very close second to my favorite thing of this expansion.
I honestly think it's mine because it's my favorite thing because even though Prison of Elders is amazing, people still find ways to cheat and do weird stuff to mess up the game. I mean, you don't have to do that, but I mean, a lot of people do that. But in Trials of Osiris, you can't cheat. This is your skill versus other team's skill. It is pure just skill going off here. I mean, of course, some...
You can be carried, though.
You can be carried, yes. But the point is, like, it instead of, you know, cheesing the bridge on Crota, you can't do that in Trials of Osiris. You have to work for your loot, and it's really rewarding.
Yeah, that... The best thing about this expansion as a whole is, like, Varix, you have to work to get that armor core specifically, and you go back and you buy it. Like, it's not super RNG. Some of this expansion is still RNG, but, like, a lot of it has gone down to, like, you work, you do this, you get this reward. Like, it's a guaranteed thing. Mm-hmm. And Trials is very much that. It's... The best thing about Trials for me is, like, I'm not even one of these guys, but I know that there are guys out there that mainly just play PvP.
Yeah, this is great,
like,
for them, too.
PvP is their thing, and now there is an end-game PvP, as in, you get rewards that are worth it for playing PvP. Mm-hmm. Whereas if you played PvP before, I felt like it was a waste of time. You know what I mean?
True.
But so just for those PvP guys out there, I'm super, super happy.
On top of it, I think the Trials of Osiris gear is like the best looking gear in the game too. It's amazing.
The
Especially
Warlock
Titan.
Gear is. Freaking...
Have you seen my Titan?
The Warlock gear is ridiculous. I love the Warlock gear. I'm not a big fan of the Titan gear, to be honest.
Just wait, mate. You just keep going. I'm gonna post something on Twitter.
Oh gosh. I've seen Titan. Your Titan. I'll show it to the stream when you post it, though.
Okay.
Or the not the stream, you know, the podcast. But.
Yes, Trials of Osiris. It's amazing.
Yeah, the Warlock.
Prison Elders is amazing.
It's all super good.
Warlock clutches for the win.
Oh, man.
Especially mine. Oh, my gosh. I'm so proud of that.
Oh, also, for people who don't know, basically, Trials of Osiris, this is how it goes. You get a scorecard from Brother Vance. Your scorecard holds up to 9 wins and 3 losses. If you get 9 wins, you're done. If you get 3 losses, you're done. And you have to turn in your thing. And basically, at Brother Vance, there are rewards at certain tiers. As in, there's a package of 2 wins, there's a package of 3, blah, blah, blah. And up to 9. And 9, there's a package with super good stuff at, like, you know, whatever in the middle. There's 5, there's a chest piece or the armor of the week. And then I think 2 more is the weapon, right? I'm sure you know this.
If 5 is the chest piece. 6 is the first package.
Yeah, well, then it's
the first legendary package, and then it's the next one.
Okay, there we go. I was correct. But so, yeah, and each, like, that's why I think it's so great, because, like, you get rewards based on how well you do. You have 7 wins, you get this. It's awesome. Also, if you get 9 wins without having a loss on your scoreboard, you unlock a new social space that they had not told us about. So it's awesome.
Yeah,
you go in. It's basically, you know, it's tied to the lore of Osiris. But basically the best part is you go down this hallway, this bridge, basically. And on this middle platform, there's this giant Egyptian chest that you open. You have a chance of exotics. And you also have a chance of Trials of Osiris weapons with elements on them, which is awesome. Which you cannot get from the normal Brother Vance vendor. Brother Vance sells the regular one, but not the ones with elements on. So, just for an example, we did the flawless run twice. Me, Eric, and Ryan did it 2 times. Eric did another third.
With Dustin Legary and his friend Revolt.
That helmet goes perfectly with that.
I love this helmet. It's the Vanguard helmet.
I think I have that helmet, actually.
It's the House of Wolves one, the second one, is really cool. I ascended it, so.
I just, the main thing that I don't like about the Titan, yeah, you made it look good, but, like, on the shoulder pieces and on the legs, there's just eyes. Like, I get that it's the symbol, but, like, there's just eyes on your armor. I'm not a big fan of it.
See, but, I just realized this. You see my boots? Those are not the Exile boots. These are the Watcher boots. There's two different sets, armor sets, apparently, for Charles of Osiris. I did not know why.
Also, this emblem that that Eric is rocking is basically for going flawless. So, yes, like, I will flaunt that emblem forever. Because I'm super proud of it. So yeah, go play Destiny, people. It's really freaking good. This for now. It's great. After we should wait until Ryan gets on tonight. He said he was gonna be back at like, he gets off work at like 10:10. So at like 10:30, my time. We can do our last 34.
Yeah.
We could I might play Hohokam until then, try and knock that off of my off of my backlog. The Flash. Let's play. The Flash, dude. Oh my gosh. So it wrapped up. It had its finale last Tuesday. And basically the finale was one of the best things pretty much ever.
Pretty much ever.
The finale itself was an insanely good episode. Like, it was just, it was a really, really, really good episode.
The pacing was well, and the acting was amazing. I mean, everything about it was, like, technically.
The last 15 minutes were just...
Yeah, the last 15 were crazy. So, I mean, spoilers.
Yeah, spoilers. We're just going to go into spoilers, it right now.
Right here.
Right now.
Everyone dies.
Dude, the best... This might be my favorite moment. My favorite moment might be where they build this up for, like, 40 minutes of them going into... Of him, he's like, all right, I'm going to do this. I'm going to go back. I'm going to save my mom.
Yeah.
But immediately when he gets there... Future Barry looks at him
and does this
head shake. He looks at him, puts his hand out, and shakes his head. He's like, and then runs off. And then, what was best about that was, like, they built it up for 40 minutes, and that head shake changed everything instantly. You know what I mean? That was awesome. It was awesome.
You got to say bye to his mom.
Yeah. That was good.
I hope his mom, like, understood, which it was her dying moment. I'm pretty sure she believed him. I don't know.
Yeah.
I'd like to think so.
Yeah, she was a little confused, but she seemed like she believed it. I thought it was so sweet. She was like, "You look just like my father," and then he went on to explain it.
Yeah.
Man, there was so much good. And then the flying through time to punch Harrison through the sphere.
Oh yeah, that was
so perfect because he was in the time travel machine and he looked so happy.
He saw Jay's helmet.
Yeah, that was great too.
That was great.
That doesn't make any sense, but it was great. But basically, like, oh dude, he was in the time thing and he was ready. He elevated himself in the air. He was smiling. He looked like he was about to cry. Like a tear was about to go down his face. And he he looked at the time thing, like in front of him, the wormhole, and smiled and just went, home. And then Barry freaking charges through and punches him in the face.
Right through the glass.
And the punch was like so strong that it like knocked everyone on the ground. Everyone was just on the ground. And then it just gets all crazy. What was your favorite moment of the finale?
That
legitimately was your favorite?
I think so, because seeing like all the time, the different Barrys in one spot, and then Barry just like is emotional and comes out and freaking destroys the time pod thing.
Yeah, the time pod. I like that. Yeah. But... Dude, honestly, my honestly, I think that with such a great episode as it was, I think that might have been the worst cliffhanger I've ever seen.
Probably. I mean, it for some reason, it's not bothering me too much.
Yeah.
But, it is a bad cliffhanger.
It bothered me when I first saw it, and now I'm kind of okay with it because I've accepted it.
The whole episode was great.
Yeah, so. Yeah. But the... when I first saw it, I was like... basically just like mouth gaping open. I was just...
you want to do that?
I told Eric and Andrew this. Basically, what was the worst thing about this cliffhanger was that they did it and it ended, and then they immediately in the credits cut to the two executive producers that were like laughing and smiling because they were super happy for season two. But at the same time, the way it happened, it seemed like they were laughing at our pain. Like it ended.
You guys
like,
have to wait another
hey,
year.
Guys, we're really excited about season two. We know what we're doing, but you don't know.
You have no idea how it pans out in the future, but we do.
Frick, man. What a cliffhanger. That could change the entire DC CW universe. And we don't know what happened.
Flashpoint.
It's very possible.
I mean, the world is ending. The one that Barry's in right now. It is ending.
Grant Gustin said that they might, that they, it's very possible for them to do an Earth 1, Earth 2 type thing in season 2, where there's like parallel dimensions.
Ooh.
Like, frick, dude. Holy
crap. That's pretty trippy. We're going to need, like, a list. Like, see what's going on. Like, okay, this happened, and then this happened. Okay, this is this Earth, and this is this Earth.
Yeah. Holy crap.
You're going to need a freaking notepad.
I'm so excited for Flash Season 2. Arrow Season 4 is going to be a lot different from what
I've
heard. It's
going to be happier. Green Arrow.
Honestly, I want to know what season 4 of Arrow is because of the Arrow ending.
Felicity dies.
Hopefully.
And he gets with Laurel because that's how it's supposed to go.
It's not going to happen. It's not going to happen. But remember when we all didn't want him to end up with Laurel? Remember that?
Yeah.
Remember when we all used to love Felicity?
Laurel was great. Now, Felicity's horrible, lines, getting emotional way too much for no reason. She's the side character. She's just supposed to be cute and funny randomly, not this thing.
It's awful. Anyways.
I don't know.
Yeah, she's awful. But I'm very excited for Arrow's. I'm super excited for Flash Season 2 because holy crap, that ending. I'm super excited for the Legends of Tomorrow because holy crap, that trailer
and Flash
and
is
all
in it,
of
so
the
it's
news.
Much Flash,
Flash, freaking Sarah, freaking Firestorm, Captain Cold, all of like the best characters. Ray,
Rory.
Rory, freaking apparently Cyborg,
Captain
maybe
Jack Harkness,
Captain Jack Sparrow, like they're all there. Oh, but
Captain Jack Sparrow.
Yep.
But, Harkness.
I know. I said Sparrow.
is this Disney now?
Yes. But I'm super excited for those two for that reason. But for Arrow, I'm super excited because what? Like, what are they going to do? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That season 3 finale was just like, okay, how are they? What are they going to do next? I have no idea. No idea. Like, with The Flash, I can make theories and blah, blah, blah. But, like, Arrow, I got no idea how they're going to freaking throw that in.
Yeah, I don't. It's going to be weird. Like, okay, what? They were doing what at the end of the show? It was just
driving off into the sunset.
Like, okay.
Dingle was, like, no longer his friend. Like, Roy's gone.
And at the end of this, freaking Oliver's happy? What?
Yeah, I don't know where they're going to go from that. That was weird.
But Green Arrow, you know?
Gosh, dang it.
I just want it to happen for some reason. You know? Dude, when is freaking the 100 coming
back? The beginning of 2016. Beginning of 2016.
Really?
Not even in the fall. They're going to start again. But, unlike The Flash and Arrow, the 100 is basically going to start and go until it ends. Like, that's their goal. They're starting it so late so that they can just start it and air all 14-16 episodes until it ends. Like, there's no breaks. That's their goal, is for there to be no breaks.
Okay.
From what I've heard, which is good. I guess I'll wait for that. But, right. But frick, like, freaking, man, the 100 AI, is so good.
There was AI where freaking Jaha.
I'm thinking of reading those books in the meantime, to be honest. Right. Because, I don't know. I just really want more 100 because it's so good.
Do me and you should just, like, find the episode where they, like, where, they, like, go, they fight against the people in the mountain. Where, like, the people, they trick people to think they're passed out, and then they just wake up and...
That was great. That was one of the best scenes of the whole show. Yeah.
Where's the smoke? What? And then...
Because the guards literally went, a-wah.
A-wah?
A-wah! Anyways.
Alright, so we should probably move on to...
Do you want to cover anything?
When is E3 start? I just wanted to mention that to, like, just, you know, have it, people have it fresh in
Let me Google.
Granular.
I'm almost positive that I know the dates, but I don't fully know.
But it's soon. We're going to see Star Wars and a bunch of other stuff, probably Destiny stuff.
Yeah. June 16th through 18th.
All right.
So, again, basically, like,
four pretty much.
Yeah, I'm very excited for E3.
Half-Life 3?
Not gonna happen.
Next week, I'll have a better camera. I'm gonna buy that.
Eric says he's getting a camera, which will be awesome.
It's not going to be, like, the best one on the market, but I'm going to get one that
you
has
a PlayStation. You should get the best one on the market. The best one on the market is, like, $50, $60.
Yeah, I know.
So, you know.
Which I can't afford, but I want...
But, like, once you do that, you don't even have to worry about it until 4K.
Dollars, I can still get ESO and then buy Witcher 3 again.
Logitech C920 is $65.57.
Okay.
But then you legitimately just don't have to worry about it.
Yeah, and I'll have a job by then, so.
Oh, snap! Big place.
Actually, I have a job.
Sorry. You haven't started yet.
Not working.
Yeah. Did you want to talk about this Joker picture?
Yes. Freaking weird. I saw it on an IGN comment. You know, they're very trolly, but, like, this is weird. I'm trying to, like... See, I haven't seen much of, like, old Joker stuff.
Yeah, I don't see anything too wrong with this picture.
Neither do I guess. But, like, from what I've seen in terms of Joker stuff, this just looks weird to me. I know that he's very... I mean, why does the Joker have a freaking sports car? Honestly.
Yeah, they're going a completely new route with the Joker, obviously, with the dumb tattoos.
I mean, he's not rich or anything.
He's apparently rich in this one. Apparently. I've basically decided to just throw all my previous thoughts out the window and just...
Out the window!
Out the window! But...
Android, out the window!
But, yeah, I don't expect anything...
I just need to, like, clear my head and rethink my life or something, because I always think of Joker as this crazy, dark dude that kills people for fun and weird experimental ways. I'm sure it's still the same, but, like, the appearance that they're giving off with this is just really different, and it's freaking me out a little. So.
The Joker in the Arkham series is my favorite Joker.
Yeah, he's a very good Joker.
But,
one of the Dark Knight movies where the pencil was involved. That was a good one.
Everyone loves Heath Ledger.
Heath Ledger.
He's great.
Rip.
Christian Bale wasn't great, though. That's a horrible Batman movie. Anyways, just throw all your previous thoughts about the Joker out the window and just expect something new, because they're gonna give you something new, mate.
That neon green hair, though.
That I kind of, I'm definitely okay with that.
Yeah.
That's cool. I like that, actually.
This is the tattoos. Why?
Yeah, tattoos are dumb. I don't know. Maybe it'll make sense in the story. But the drope. We're not going to forget it this week.
Yes.
We're not going to forget it. We'll probably forget it. While I'm going to the blog, I'll see another article and be like, hey, what's this? Let's talk about this. Oh, we'll see you guys later.
Ryan Clements, PlayStation Powerhouse.
Hey! Eric got the reference this time. So, this is what you can purchase on your PlayStation consoles in the upcoming Tuesday. Arcade Archives Crazy Climber, PS4.
Crazy Climber.
Crazy Climber is an action game produced by blah 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 in 1980.
Okay, hold on. Let me get this straight. This looks like a Flash game on the PS4.
Yeah. It's because it's an arcade game. Arcade Archives Ninja Kid, PS4, another arcade game. Arcania The Complete Tale, PS4 retail.
That looks cool.
Looks like an RPG type thing.
Already available via digital. Okay.
Ah, okay. Yeah, good luck competing against The Witcher, Arcania The Complete Tale.
Yeah.
Badland, the Game of the Year edition, PS4, PS3,
Never
Vita.
Heard of it. Looks kind of like Limbo from that picture.
Yeah.
Speaking of Limbo, I wanted to say something. I've played that game 5 times. You should play it right now. So
it's on the backlog.
I know.
Invisimals, the Resistance.
What? Invisimals is like
Invisimals.
Invisible animals.
Wait, is that seriously what that is? That would be awful.
I don't know, but if that's a thing, what like, it sounds what's like. The point? If you're going to make like invisible animals, are they always going to be invisible to where you can't see the models or anything?
I doubt that's what it is.
I mean, look, there's, like, dots where it looks like there's animals or, like, characters. Are they invisible? You just can't see it.
Read the description. I highly doubt it's about animals. That the name very much suggests it, but it doesn't. I don't know. Magicka 2 for PS4.
Magicka 2. I've heard
Magicka 2. Everyone likes Magicka, except for me. Mega Man 8 PS1 Classic. Octodad Dadly's Catch. So you can... You can have all your octopus adventures on the go. Roundabout for the PS4 with a picture of a real woman standing there glaring at the camera with a train uniform and a what?
What is okay? What
okay,
is
okay? I'm going and I'm zooming in on this for the video podcast people to see this.
I'm gonna look at this game and see what it is.
Do people see this crap? What is going on with this?
Oh picture? My gosh, I know what this is. I've seen someone stream this once. It's literally a live action game. Like, all the cutscenes have real people, but when you go in the game, it's like some cartoony thing. You run over people and kill them. That's literally the goal, to run over in people and kill them.
That's freaking
it's
weird.
It's the dumbest thing. And you can get bonus multipliers, and yeah, the cutscenes are made by real people.
That is odd. Ultra Street Fighter 4. There you go. Ultra Street Fighter for your fighting game fans. Vitamin Z for the PS Vita. Don't know what that is. Looks Splatoon-esque. Weird Park, The Final Show. PS3.
You could say it looks a little weird.
Wow.
Yeah, it looks like a Teenage Mutant Turtle on a little bike there.
Dude, it does. Holy crap. I did not think that before, but holy crap. Look at it. Little Donatello, little Leonardo, right into the weird park. Alright, well, that's it. I gotta go play games.
Does Ryan Clements really like Metal Gear Solid Rising?
I guess.
Because he just always has that picture.
Well, a PlayStation avatar is sacred because they basically don't care about it anymore, so they don't release new ones. They don't even let you change it on the PS4. They don't let you buy avatars on the PS4. You have to go on the PS3 and do it. But it's awful. But so basically it's like once you pick one and find one you like, you're just going to leave it there forever. Like my Cole thing is just going to be there forever. I'm always going to have the Infamous 2 Cole as my avatar. So that's his avatar. That's not like a profile pic for the PlayStation. It's linked to your thing.
Yeah.
So, Let's get out of here. Do you have anything random? Because I don't. Actually, I do, if you don't.
Yes, I do. I have...
Is this going to be the first ever repeat, or is it
not? No. It's my application.
that can't be repeated.
Yeah.
Not at all.
My perfect application. It was copied because it's beautiful. Oh, my cousin helped me do it, and she has really great handwriting.
Yeah, so I have awful handwriting.
I mean, just look how good name looks.
That's great. Mine is.
This is my address the worst. And everything, so you can guys hack my life.
Yeah. You guys hack my life. GG.
Dead now.
You're about to get swatted.
Oh no.
They're coming for you. Well, I don't really. We'll end on that. That's a good application. That's a good random thing. You're probably never gonna see that ever again. So that was very much a good random item for the week.
Yep.
So everyone, go play House of Wolves. Go enjoy it.
Go play it's games.
Really good.
Fun.
Have some fun. Just fling something to the.
There is a bottle cap. And yeah. Just flung back here somewhere. I meant to throw it that way, but.
That would have been great. Right towards the camera. But clear your backlog. You know, sit down, play all these games that you haven't gotten a chance to.
If you're over 21, have a beer.
So, yeah.
Sit there with popcorn and a beer and just play Destiny with your good pals.
Your pals, your buddies, your
yes. Don't do raids drunk though. It's really annoying.
No, don't do it.
It really is.
Don't be that guy going on LFG drunk and or high.
Yes.
And or high. That has happened before. Really all right. Well, that's it. Oh wait. Reach out to Eric on Twitter at EricBailey15. Reach out to me at TBCIEC.
Random stuff.
TBESTIAC. You can go to my Twitch channel. I will be streaming at least every day, at least an hour a day. Actually, I don't know about tonight, but most of the time I stream at least. I stream once a day. I try to. So I've been doing that lately. I got back to it. It's great. Me and Grunt and Reckless hang out. It's awesome. So twitch.tv/TBCIEC games, youtube.com/TBCIEC. That is it. Add us on PSN. Bye.